Sir, I read a statement made by you regarding the questions, repeated questions that the non-Muslims always raise against Islam, and they are not more than 17 or 15, you said. So my question is there, is that, is there any booklet written by you or cassette that we can check so that if we learn, we tell them, or I have to get from here and there different cassettes? Thank you.
Well, the question that I'd mentioned earlier when I'd come in the last clip, that there are hardly 15 to 20 questions, and I do agree with him, which are the common questions the non-Muslim ask. And that's the stepping, how a person wants to become a part-time day or full-time day. There are 15 to 20 questions which the non-Muslim pose against Islam. And if you master these 15 to 20 questions, then you'll be able to convince more than 90% of non-Muslims. More than 90% non-Muslim have only these questions. So we have a philosophy that instead of talking 1,000 good points about Islam, what we do, first we remove these misconceptions that they have, which are hardly maximum. Some have 5, some have 10, but they all revolve around these 15 to 20 common questions. If you can master these, once the misconception is removed, then if you speak even 10 good points about Islam, they'll accept it. Otherwise, even if you speak 1,000 good points, they'll say, "Ye Musliman, he married more than one wife. Ye Musliman, he intrigued the woman." You know, so remove this misconception first, then even if you speak 10 good points about Islam, they will accept it. Clear question. Is there any book available? Brother Azam mentioned earlier that it's available in writing, but it has not come in book form yet. There are at least about 6-7 of my books under print, but due to these lecture tours and being busy in Bombay, this project has been delayed a lot, which should have been there or a couple of years ago. Inshallah, do pray that this year, at least within a couple of months, before 5 months, it should be released, inshallah. But regarding the second part, are there any video cassettes available? Yes, brother. There are video cassettes available. There are approximately 25 different titles available in Jeddah. There are more than 75 available in Bombay. Out here, there are more than 25 video cassettes available, which if you want any question on women, you can take Women That's in Islam, part 1 and part 2. If you want any question on Quran, you can take the Quran, God's Word. If you want any question on science, you can take Quran and Modern Science, Conflict or Conciliation. There are various cassettes. If you can manage to take about 10 cassettes, most of these questions will be covered with. Hope that's the question.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Jameel. There's one thing you started very good today, that we are honored in the first one, alhamdulillah. And then the club equally is our responsibility, so-called. So what do you feel our responsibility is? First, to represent ourselves in terms of deeds or use, as one of our brother questioned, that below the economic, to use dollars or whatsoever. So our deeds are most important for Dawah work, or just memorizing some questions and inviting and impressing them. So fundamentally, what is our responsibility in terms of honored by Allah, that we should be ourselves a workable answers to them, or only a memorizing questions and answer to be answered them? Thank you.
You have the question, which is more important? To improve our deeds is more important, or just learning the answers of few questions and doing dawah, that's important? Whether if you heard my talk, I gave 4 criteria that are important for entering Jannah. Faith, righteous deed, exhorting people to truth, that is in Dawah and Islah, and exhorting people to patient perseverance, according to Surah Al-Asr, chapter 103, verse number 1 to 3. All 4 are equally important. Salah is important. But if I tell the person in a medical college, see, start doing Salah from now, most of them will not agree. A few may, inshallah, agree. If I tell them, see, this is the reason why Islam is more superior to other ways of life, and you tell to the other people, whenever anyone knows the answer of a particular question, he would love anyone asking that question. Suppose in a classroom, if you know the answer to the question which the teacher is going to ask you, you would but naturally like the teacher asking you the question, so that you can show to the world, hey, you can show to the classroom, I know the answer. But the moment the person knows the answer to the 15 to 20 question, he starts doing dawah to the non-Muslim. He starts going and knocking at the doors. Moment he knocks at the door, he realizes, let's see, Islam is much better. When he tries and convince the non-Muslim, he himself realizes, immediately his deeds start improving. Both are important. Deeds is equally important, even dawah is equally important. But you can't say, I'll do only dawah and will not improve my deeds. It is a simultaneous process. The moment you start doing dawah, inshallah, automatically your deeds start improving. If you say, first I'll improve my deeds very well, then start doing dawah, that time may never come. But one thing you should realize while doing dawah, brother, that you should not preach that thing which you yourself not follow. For example, suppose I'm alcoholic, which I'm not, alhamdulillah. Suppose I'm alcoholic. I cannot tell to the other person, don't have alcohol. But yet I can tell him, believe in one God, that Quran is the word of God, don't have pope. Other things I can say. But while I'm telling this, I'm reminded that Quran says in Surah Maida chapter 5 verse number 90, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu innama al-khamru wal maisiru wal anzabu wal aslamu rijsun min amali shaitan fajtanibu lahum tuflihun. That oh, you believe? Ya ayyuhallazina amanu innama al-khamru wal maisiru, most certainly intoxicants and gambling, wal anzabu wal aslamu, dedication of stones, divination of arrows, rijsun min amali shaitan, these are Satan's handiwork. Fajtanibu lahum tuflihun, abstain from this handiwork that I may prosper. So by the time I'm doing dawah, I also know that the Quran is saying that intoxicants is haram. So I'm trying to improve that tomorrow somebody will question me that I'm doing dawah, why are you having alcohol? So immediately I see to it that I will stop having alcohol. So by the time I can preach the other things, the moment I stop having alcohol, I can preach that also. And I'm sure there are Muslims who at least do few good deeds. At least they believe in one Allah. Start with that. Even if you don't pray, we have seen the results in Bombay, alhamdulillah. Those people who used to never pray, they offer 5 days salah. They offer alhamdulillah good beard. We didn't learn to put the beard. They themselves realize, alhamdulillah. They fast, they go for hajj, alhamdulillah. It comes. But the moment you realize, because we ourselves, though we say we are Muslims, they educate so-called apologetic Muslims, they say verbally they are Muslims, but they don't agree that Quran is the best way of life. The moment they start doing dawah and when they give the answer to the non-Muslim, they themselves get the answer that Islam is the perfect way of life. And the moment they get the answer, they realize that whatever the Quran says is right and they start following it. And the more dawah you do, the more Islamic you become. Alhamdulillah. Hope that answers it.
I appreciate your consent, but my practical experience is that as you are giving example of schools and teaching, and you are emphasizing that we always have the good speaking guys, and particularly younger kids, that are the better way to adopt and train them for dawah work. That's absolutely, I do agree with it. But the same thing, the grasping power of youngers are more and fundamental as a good foundation for others. But equally, seeing is believing. Let's general recognized fact is, we respect Islam. And that's what I want to quote, what non-Muslims normally used to say in my English medium school, that we respect Islam but we hate Muslims. Well, in this thing, equally they say and agree that good etiquettes binds each other and good faces only attracts. So having this understood and coming back to our fundamentals, our responsibility towards Allah, the Creator. So our basic responsibility is that we represent ourselves more and more, concentrate on that. And then they get our answers in our deeds itself. If we, and nothing is in.
The deeds and etiquette, they attract. And they say that the Muslims, they aren't good, etc. So, and I do agree with him. And I said in my answer that deeds are equally important. But if you say that I'll improve my deed and then start doing dawah, that time may never come. And I do agree, when you're doing dawah, brother, what you have to emphasize, that don't look at the Muslims to know about Islam. Look at the Quran. If you have to look at any example of a Muslim, the best example is our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Don't look at me or him or you for knowing what Islam is. For knowing what Islam is, you have to read the Holy Quran. There are black sheep in every community. Don't you think that black sheep among the Christians? They say Islam was spread with a sword. Who was Hitler? A Christian. Who was Mussolini? A Christian. See, the majority of rape takes place where? In America. Who are the majority rapists? Christians. That does not mean that just because a group of people are bad, that means their religion is bad. You have to give the example, brother, that suppose if I have to analyze a car, suppose there is a good Mercedes car, and if I have to know